Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint the legendary and fabled Blood Angel, Dominion Zephon, also known as the Bringer of Sorrow, the Exile, the Twice-Born, and the Exarch of the High Host. By following this video, you can easily transfer any of the techniques and methods to other Horus Heresy-themed Blood Angels in your army. So pick up those paintbrushes, shake those paint pots, and let's get started. So the first thing that we need to do is undercoat the model. And in this instance, we've made two sub-assemblies, the torso and the head. For these assemblies, we've used Mephiston Red on the torso and Grey Sear on the head. The first paint that we're going to use is Mephiston Red and apply this all over the torso. What this will do is make it really easy for us to tidy up if we make any mistakes because it has a slightly different finish to the undercoat. So what I'm going to do is get a couple of dollops onto the palette. There's one more. And get some water, thin it out to what I want it to be. So it just needs a little bit more water there. And then what I'm going to do is start applying it all over the model, making sure to keep the paint moving and also not worrying about getting it onto the pouches or any other bits because we will be painting over them later. Once it's dry, just do a second thin coat. With that base coat now applied, we need to move into finishing the red armor. And for this, we'll be using Flesh Tearer's Red and applying that into the panel lines. We're then going to use Evil Sun Scarlet as a thick edge highlight, and then Troll Slayer Orange as a thin edge highlight. And finally, we're going to use Tau Light Ochre as a spot highlight, really just to make the armor pop. So the first thing I need to do is just get some Flesh Tearer's Red onto the palette and get a little bit of water, not too much at all, and apply that in, and then get my brush to a nice sharp point. And what we're going to look to do is just apply this into the recesses. Don't worry if this takes a while. That'll be okay because it'll be worth it in the end because it's going to add lots of definition to your armor. If you make any mistakes, just tidy up with Mephiston Red and cut back in. So the next thing to do will be to use Evil Sun Scarlet as an edge highlight. I'm just running this over all the edges of the red armor. So with that stage now complete, the next thing to do is to use Troll Slayer Orange. And what we're looking to do is just paint within the lines of our first edge highlight. Just doing it there. And for this, I'm using a small layer brush. So with the second edge highlight now complete, the next thing to do will be to add a spot highlight. So to give you an example, with the spot highlight, I'm going to look to add just a spot to the bottom corners like so. There we go, and there. And then around the top edges, like with the circle here with the engine, I'm just going to drag the edge of my brush just to show some definition and give the highest point of light. And then I'm going to go around the model doing the same thing. So with the spot highlight now finished, the red armor is complete. The next thing that we need to do is move on to the black details. And for this, we'll be starting with a base coat of Abaddon Black, followed by highlights of Eshin Grey, Dawnstone, and Administratum Grey. When doing this, don't forget to paint the hair on the head following the same steps as well. So what I'm looking to do is just to get some Abaddon Black onto my palette. So another dollop there, maybe one more. And get some water and thin that down, making sure to get my brush to a nice neat point. And then what I want to do is pick out all the black details. So for instance, it's the leather on the holster as well as the armor's ribbing. Just make sure to check the box art if you get confused where the other black details are. So with the black now blocked in, the next thing to do is use Eshin Grey as an edge highlight. Just using the side of my brush and bringing it along the edge of the holster. And I'll also do the ribbing on the undersuit of the armor. So So with the Eschen Grey now applied, the next thing to do is to apply Dawnstone inside the layer of the Eschen Grey, making sure to get your brush to a nice sharp point and just gliding it down the edge using the side of the brush. So with the Dawnstone complete, the leather details are finished. The next thing I'm going to do is use a Ministratum Grey as a spot highlight on the ribbing, just to set a little bit of difference between that and the leather details. At the same time, just use it on the hair, and you want to do it where the hairline meets and then a little bit around the crown. So with that spot highlight now complete, the black details are all finished. The next thing that we're going to need to do is to move on to all the metallics. What we'll be starting with is the silver details. The first paint that we'll be using is Iron Warriors for all the basing. Then we're going to move on to Nun Oil as a wash. And finally, we're going to use Stormhost Silver just to bring it back up again as an edge highlight. So what I'm going to do is get some Iron Warriors onto my palette. A little bit more because there's quite a few silver details on this model. Use some water just to thin it out so it's not too goopy, and get my brush to a nice point. Actually, I'm thinking I need a little bit more water. There we go, that's what I need. And get my brush to a neat point. And then I'm just going to start applying it to the model. If you get confused where the silver details are, just check the box art. With the base layer now applied, the next thing to do is apply non-oil as a wash all over it. Make sure not to fill up your brush too much because you want to keep good control of it and keep it off the red details. So with the non-oil now applied, you can see all the silver metallic areas where I've applied it on the model. The next thing to do will be to apply Stormhost Silver as an edge highlight over those areas. And with that stage now complete, the edge highlight on the silver and the layer on the sword is now finished. The next thing that we're going to need to do is do all the gold details, and for this we'll be using Retributor Armor. We're then going to apply Gilliman Flesh in order to darken down the gold as well as give it a more aged appearance. Then we're going to liven it up with Skullcrusher Brush as a layer, and finally use Stormhost Silver as an edge highlight. So the first thing I'm going to need to do is get some Retributor Armor onto my palette. One more, get some water and wash it down. Making sure again to get my brush to a nice neat point. There we go. And then we're going to start applying this to all the gold details. For this, I'm going to be using a small layer brush because I don't want to get any of the gold onto my red armor. And if you're struggling to know where to apply the gold, just make sure to check the box art to help yourself out. So with the gold now base, the next thing to do will be to add some Gilliman Flesh onto it. This will help to give it some definition as well as age it. So just make sure to keep the paint moving when using Gilliman Flesh. If it starts to pool, just soak it up with a dried brush. So with the Gilliman Flesh now applied and dried, the next thing to do is to use Skullcrusher Brass as an edge highlight, making sure to use the flat of the brush when doing it. So with the gold now layered up, the final thing to do is to add some Stormhost Silver as a spot highlight. So what I'm going to look to do is just put it on the very tips of all the edges, just to bring it up and sharpen it. So you can do that on the edges there, on the tops of the studs, going through with it, and then finally just on the tips of the wings. You don't want to do too much because you don't want to make the gold look a bit too silver. So with that final spot highlight complete, all the metallic details are finished. The next thing that we're going to need to do is to change our water pot because we don't want any of those metallic flakes corrupting the rest of our details going forward. So once we've got a fresh pot of water, the first thing that we're going to do is look to tackling all the blood details adorning the armor. For this, we're going to use Phoenician purple as a base. We're then going to move into non-oil as a wash just to dull it down, and then bring it back up with Phoenician purple. We're then going to use Jean Stealer purple as a highlight with a final spot highlight of Slaanesh Grey. So the first thing I'm going to do is get the Phoenician purple onto my palette. And another one. Get some water and apply that to it and get it nice and thin. And also get my brush to a nice neat point because we don't want to get any of this onto our nice armor. So what we're going to look to do is just to pick up all the little blood drops that you see around the armor with the Phoenician purple. So just make sure to take a close look at the armor and pick out all of them. If you're struggling for where they are, don't forget to check the box art. So with the blood drops now based, the next thing to do is to wash them with non-oil. So with the non-oil now applied, the next thing to do is to layer the bottom end of the blood drops with Phoenician purple. So with the blood drops now laid up, the next thing to do is to apply Jean Stealer purple as a highlight. And we're going to do this just around the bottom half of the blood drops and almost like an L shape. This will help to add some definition to them. So with the Jean Stealer purple now applied, the next thing to do is to use Slaanesh Grey as a spot highlight right at the bottom bit of the blood drop. After that, do a tiny dot highlight right at the top of the drop. So with that final dot highlight finished, the blood drops are now complete. The next thing that we're going to need to do is move on to the green frag grenade. And for this, we'll be using Castellan Green. We're then going to wash that with non-oil, layer it back up with Strachan Green, and then do a final highlight of Nurgling Green. So what I'm going to need to do is get some Castellan Green onto my palette. And then wash it off and get a little bit of water because we don't want to thin it down too much. There we go. And get the brush to a nice sharp point. Start applying that all over the frag grenade. For this, I'm going to be using a small layer brush because I don't want to get any of the green onto the other completed details. So with the green applied, the next thing to do is to wash it with non-oil. So with the wash now applied, the next thing to do is to use Strachan Green as a layer. And all you're looking to do is just to pick out the raised details of the frag grenade. So that's these little bumps here. So with that layer applied, the next thing to do is to use Nurgling Green and use it as an edge highlight. And then just pick out the edges of the raised area. So with that edge highlight finished, the frag grenade is now complete. The next thing that we're going to need to do is to move on to the scroll work, which is on the shoulder pad. And for this, we'll be using Rakarth Flesh. We're then going to shade it with Agrax Earthshade, layer it back up with Rakarth Flesh, and then do a final edge highlight of Pallid Witch Flesh. So the first thing I'm going to need to do is get my Rakarth Flesh onto the palette. Get a little bit more. Now this paint is quite thin, so I'm actually not going to apply that much water to it at all. But just put a little bit in there to get it to the right mixture. And then what I'm going to do is just start to apply that all over the scroll work. For this, I'm using a medium layer brush, and I'm just going to try and be as neat as I can because I don't want to get that on any of the gold. With that now done, the Rakarth Flesh is complete. You may need to do a couple of coats as I have done here. The next thing to do is to apply Agrax Earthshade all over it. So So what I'm going to do is just gently brush the Agrax Earthshade across the scroll and then get it into the recesses as well. So now that the Agrax Earthshade is dry, the next thing to do is to layer back up with Ragarth Flesh, making sure to keep the Agrax Earthshade in the deepest recesses. So with that layer now complete, you can see we've got the Agrax Earthshade in the top left and the top right of the scroll. The next thing that we need to do is apply Pallid Witch Flesh as an edge highlight along all the edges. Just making sure to use the side of your brush when doing this. For this, I'll be using a small layer brush as well. Just take your time, and if you make any mistakes, just go back over with Ragarth Flesh. So with that edge highlight now finished, the scroll work is complete. The next thing that we're going to have to do is to move on to the skull, which is on the shoulder pad. And for this, we'll be using Celestia Grey as a base coat. So what I'm going to do is just get some of it onto my palette. Get a little bit of water and just mix that in. Get my brush to a nice thin point. Making sure to twist it and then bringing it up. And what I'm gonna do is just start applying that all over the skull. For this, I'm using a medium layer brush and just making sure to be nice and neat. You'll probably find that you'll need to do a couple of layers of this. So just take your time and move on when ready. So with that base coat finished, we're gonna move on to completing the skull. To start with, we're going to use Space Wolves Grey mixed with Contrast Medium and apply that all over the skull. And then we're going to use Ulthuan Grey as a layer and finally some White Scar as an edge highlight. So the first thing I need to do is get roughly 4 dollops of Contrast Medium onto my palette. Put it in, wash off the brush, quick dry, and then get 1 brushful of Space Wolves Grey, mix that all in. Get the brush to a nice neat point and get off all the excess. And then start to apply that all over the skull, making sure to keep it moving and try and be neat with this application as well. When it's dry, do a second layer of it. The reason why we're using Space Wolves Grey is when it's finished, it's going to give a slightly different tone of shading, which will help to separate it from the scroll work. So with that second coat now dry, you can see the skull has a nice blue hue. The next thing that we're going to do is use Ulthuan Grey as a layer and just layer all over the upper sections of the skull. So with that layer finished, the last thing to do is to add White Scar as an edge highlight just to the most raised areas. This will be specifically just around the eyes, the teeth, the nose, and a little bit around the top of the skull. And with that final edge highlight now complete, the torso is done. The next thing that we need to do is to move into the flesh details. And for this, we'll be using Flayed One Flesh. We're then going to use Gilliman Flesh and apply it all over. Then we're going to go back into Flayed One Flesh to layer it up, moving into Screaming Skull. We're then going to use Gilliman Flesh again, just in the deepest recesses to add some definition. And finally, use Pallid Witch Flesh as an edge highlight. So the first thing that we need to do is get some Flayed One Flesh onto our palette. We're then going to use quite a bit of water here, so if I just wash that out and start applying that to the paint because we want it nice and thin. And then getting our brush to a nice sharp point and then start applying that all over the flesh, making sure to keep the paint moving and not letting it settle. Once it's done, you're going to need to do quite a few coats here just to build up the strong base. So with that stage now complete, I did about four layers, by the way. We're then going to move onto Gilliman Flesh and apply it all over, just making sure to keep the paint moving. So with the Gilliman Flesh now dry, the next thing that we're going to do is layer back up using Flayed One Flesh. And what we're going to look to do is to leave the Gilliman Flesh in the deepest recesses, as well as where the flesh meets the hairline and where the flesh meets the armor. So with that layer now finished, the next thing to do is to move on to Screaming Skull. And what we're going to do here is just paint that within the layer of what we did with the Flayed One Flesh. And this will help to add a really nice transition between the two colors. So with that layer of Screaming Skull now done, the next thing to do is to move back to Gilliman Flesh. And what I'm looking to do here is just apply that to the deepest recesses. So where I'm going to apply this is just in the mouth, like that, and then underneath the nose. I will also go on to applying it underneath the chin, and then again where the hairline meets the flesh. So with that second coat of Gilliman Flesh applied in the deepest recesses, what we're now going to do is use Pallid Witch Flesh, and I'm going to use this as a spot highlight over the most prominent features of the face. So that will be the cheeks, the nose, the nostrils, above the eyes, and the chin. So with that final highlight done, the skin is finished. The next thing that we need to do is to move on to doing the eyes as well as the teeth. And for this, we'll be using Abaddon Black to black out the eyes, and then White Scar is two spots on each side of them. And then what we're going to do is use White Scar on the teeth. So the first thing is to get some Abaddon Black onto the palette. Then a little bit of water just to thin it down. What I'm going to look to do is very carefully put it onto the eye. For this, I'm using a small layer brush. With the black now blocked in, the next thing to do is to use White Scar as two tiny little dots on each side of the eye. The best thing to do when doing this is to hold your breath. So now that we can breathe again after doing the eyes, the last thing to do here with White Scar is just pick out the teeth. And there we are. With the eyes and the teeth now done, we just need to move into the final few details. And for this, we're going to be using Barrignar Burgundy mixed in with Lamian Medium as a glaze over the lips, and then pure Barrignar Burgundy on the tongue, and then finally Stormhost Silver just to pick out that service stud on his forehead. So the first thing I need to do is get about 2 to 3 drops of Lamian Medium on the palette. So I've gone for 3 there. Wash out the brush, just dry it off, and then get some Barrignar Burgundy on the palette, and then just mix that in. So we've made this glaze. And as you can see there, a little bit more. I think that's about right. Then we're gonna roll the brush. And what I'm gonna look to do is just to gently brush that over the lips. And what this will do, just make a nice glaze for it and not make them too prominent. So with that glaze now done, we just need to move into pure Barrignar Burgundy to pick out the tongue. Just hold your breath again when you go in. So with the tongue now picked out, the last of the intricate details is complete. The final thing to do on the face is to pick out the service stud with Stormhost Silver. Once you've done that, you just need to attach the head to the rest of the body. So with the head now attached, the last thing that we need to do is to move on to the concrete detail that he is leaping off. And for this, we'll be using Mechanica Standard Grey, and then we're going to go into shading it with non-oil. The first thing I need to do is get Mechanica Standard Grey onto my palette and get quite a bit here, a little bit more, and get a tiny bit of water, mix that in, get a little bit more water. There we go. And then start applying it all over the concrete. And for this, I'm using a small base brush. With that base coat now applied, the next thing to do is to apply non-oil. And we're going to look to do this all over the base coat. So with the shade now dry, the next thing to do is to move on to the highlights. And for this, we'll be dry brushing them. The paints that I'm going to use is going to be Dawnstone and then a very light dry brush of Screaming Skull. The first thing I need to do is get some Dawnstone onto my brush and then just start to take off as much of it as I can. There you go, nice little crisscross motion there. And what I look to do is just, in a circular motion, just start to get it all onto the concrete. Just taking care when you get close to the foot. So with the Dawnstone finished, the last thing to do is to dry brush Screaming Skull over the top. And remember just to do this very gently because you only want this over the top details. And with that now done, our Dominion Zephon is complete. All that's left to do is to base the model and then to paint the rim in a color to match your army. With the model now painted and based, Dominion Zephon is ready to head off and defend the throne world against the vile traitor legions of Horus Lupercal. Now, there are just a couple of things to remember. When highlighting, take your time and try and keep your brush to a nice sharp point. When using shade or a contrast, if you overload your brush and see that the paint is pooling, just dry your brush off and then soak it up with the tip. And then finally, when using metallics, remember to clean out your water because you do not want to get any of the metallic flecks into the rest of your paint. Well, we hope you enjoyed this painting video and we hope you enjoy painting your own Horus Heresy themed Blood Angels. And we look forward to seeing you again soon. Goodbye.